Ah, yes, of course. The necessities.
Whoa, what are you doing? You can't bring that with you. Why would you need it?
Dylan, we're going to go see the universe. We're going to see amazing things.
Exactly. So what would be the point?
Imagine how amazing it would be to be completely drunk or completely high off your mind. It would be amazing.
I prefer you when you don't do that. So, this doctor person, are you sure we can even trust him?
I can't. But it's sure as hell better than staying here.
So, we're going to Blavuzeria. It's basically Earth, but it orbits a black hole.
Why are we going there?
Because basically they make devices which emit a field about that big stops cake from going stale. Don't touch anything. I don't even remember what half of this stuff does.
Alright.
Ooh, and guys, hold on tight to something. And here we are.
What's wrong now? Don't you know how to fly your own ship?
I swear you get more stubborn every day. Just because you can't get a good scan of the outside doesn't mean I can't. My screwdriver!
Dylan!
Isabella! Press the big red button! No, the other one! Me acaba la hostia, te lo juro, te lo pego, te lo ay, mato, te lo, no sé qué hago, no sé qué he hecho, joder, mi Sonic está perdido en un puto agujero negro, ¿qué hago? I think it sounds less rude in Spanish.
Doctor, what do we do now?
My screwdriver.
I'm sorry?
I've lost my screwdriver.
And Dylan.
Oh, for goodness sake, I'm gonna have to go after it and save it.
And Dylan.
Hmm? Oh, yeah. Important things first. Maybe if I pass him on the way, but the screwdriver. I really need to start leaving my shields up.
Doctor, what the hell was that thing?
A black hole. A really big black hole. A super massive black hole.
What happened to the planet?
I think it's pretty self-explanatory. No, we're in the right place, just the wrong time. See, the planet did orbit the black hole for a safe amount of time, then eventually it fell in. We just came a few thousand years late. Move politely. Ooh. Ooh. Voila! These are brilliant. These are my very special dowsing rods. They are calibrated to find Astron energy, and you only find that in two places in the entire universe. Right here in the TARDIS, and over there in my sonic screwdriver. I use it to power it. That's why I charge it on the TARDIS.
Yeah, but Doctor, we already know it's in the black hole. It's pretty obvious.
Yes, Isabella, but these will help us find exactly where in the black hole the sonic screwdriver and Dylan are. Brilliant! So now that it's locked on to the coordinates, all I need to do is program those into here. So... Ah! Got them! Brilliant! Isabella, you might want to hold on to something. Right. Well, vamos.
Doctor!
We'll be right back. Hello?
Doctor, it's me. Where are you? What happened?
I'm fine. I should be fine. And I'm in the black hole. Should be in the black hole.
Oh, hang on. 1 second.
A pen? Did you just throw a pen into a black hole?
Yeah, so you're in the black hole.
Of course I'm inside the black hole. You shouldn't litter.
But how are you alive? You should have been crushed. How is the pen still there? How do you even know it's a pen?
Of course not. This is a supermassive black hole. It doesn't shred you up until you're past the horizon.
But you are past the horizon.
No, you didn't let me finish. Shredding is a terrible word for it. It's more like fourth dimensional cross projecting. It's sort of like a fake reality sort of made off the warped version of what went in. I'm fine, basically.
So you're in a mini copy universe inside a black hole?
I'm not dead yet, and I should be okay because smaller objects get destroyed quicker, so I don't have too much time to find my sonic screwdriver. Oh, and Ethan.
Dylan!
Anyway, don't have time. Gotta find my sonic screwdriver. Sorry, ciao, bye. Is that? Hey! Not Ethan! You're alive! Brilliant! Anyway, gotta find the sonic screwdriver. Come! What?
Not Ethan?
Wait up! Doctor!
What?
Doctor!
What?
Well, what happened? Where are we? How did we get here?
We may have fallen into a supermassive black hole, probably, and been sort of copied into a pocket dimension on the surface of the black hole itself.
I'm dead, aren't I? This is what it feels like to be dead.
Dylan, this is nothing what being dead feels like. Don't be ridiculous.
Well, how would you know?
Not important right now. What is important is that we find my Sonic.
You and that bloody screwdriver. But isn't it too late? Where's Isabella?
Isabella's fine. She's in the TARDIS. And that is exactly why we need to find my sonic screwdriver, because then I can lock onto the TARDIS, and I can get us out of here, and I can also save her.
Have you done this before?
No, but it will probably, more than likely, work.
Let's go find that screwdriver.
We're never going to find the screwdriver if we stick together, so let's split up.
Okay, I'll go that way.
Righto, I'll go that way.
Oh!
Hello.
Hello.
I'm not local, what can you tell me about the village?
We don't get many strangers. I thought we were the only village in the world.
Strange. Well, I came from another village, my village, and I was wondering if there was any other villages, and, well, wouldn't you know it, I found your village, so it turns out, wouldn't you know it, there's two villages. Isn't that brilliant?
Fascinating.
I was also wondering, you haven't seen any, like, little bits of just things falling out of the sky, bright things, lights, burning things, meteorites?
This fell into my garden last night. It broke into two or three parts. Then in a flash of lightning it disappeared.
Ah, so that would be an EMP from it blowing apart. I knew I should have tightened that screw. Right, anyway.
Yep.
I have these. So, did any of it go this way?
Both pieces fell over that way when they split apart.
You want me to what?
Yes, throw your phone into the black hole. If you want to get hold of me, you've still got the TARDIS phone.
Well, that's not what I'm worried about. If my screen cracks, I'm stealing the TARDIS.
Ooh. So, this is a primitive communication device, a bit like a sort of old-fashioned-y holophone, and this here is one of my special dowsing rods. It actually works.
I don't understand. How is this going to help us find some metal pieces?
So, I'm an inventor from a village far away, and an explosion in my lab sent the thing like flying through the sky, and then it crashed in your village, so we need to find it.
And why should I help you?
Because I can then use it to fix the electronics.
Okay, what's the plan then?
So, you take that phone, and when it starts to ring and go nuts, you sort of swipe it, pick it up, answer, and also follow this thing, hold it lightly, and it points in the right direction that we need to go. So let's split up and go find the thing, okay?
Okay.
Brilliant. You go that way, I go this way. Oh, yeah. Dylan! I think I found something!
What?
Just come with me! Come! Come on! He's a madman. Hello!
Doctor, the TARDIS is doing some weird stuff. The lights have dimmed, there's a weird bell ringing going on. It doesn't sound right.
No need to worry. It just means like the Hawking field around the black hole is irritating the TARDIS.
Doctor...
So, Hawking radiation for the TARDIS is sort of like heat, so it sort of irritates it. It can stand it for a while. So basically, the TARDIS just needs to go and cool down somewhere for a little bit, and then it will come right back.
Right, you need to listen to what I'm about to say. I'm going to teach you to fly the TARDIS. You're going to need to look for a red switch on the left side panel. Flick that. That should stop the TARDIS from trying to fly away from the black hole. After you've done that, you need to put the shields up. That'll be three panels round on the left-hand corner. It's really obvious. Now you've done that, you need to go and put the brakes on. That'll stop the TARDIS from just drifting away somehow. She does have a mind of her own, sometimes. Now,
I've got to go, I'm up a tree.
Doctor, what is that thing? Some sort of portal?
Well, sort of. Basically, there are different layers to the dimension that's basically around the black hole. And the lower ones, if you want to call them lower, a bit more corrupt, that's sort of like a gap that leads to another layer.
Doctor, look!
Ooh!
Get off me!
Restrain him! Ooh, tech's a bit rustic. Fancy, though. It looks Valmirian in design.
How dare you mention the Valmirian scum? I am Hagoth. We will slaughter every Valmirian criminal in existence.
Woo! You're angrier than a Dalek. So, what's the beef between you guys, then? You and the Valmirians? Tell me.
The Valmirians captured our world and made us their slave race. But we learned. We used our tech to break free. We followed them through the universe. We imprisoned them. We destroyed them.
Hang on a minute. I know something about this. Valhof Wars, you guys rose up and overthrew and, no, you slaughtered the Valmirians by the millions, the hundreds of millions.
We did it for our freedom.
The Valmirians were an entire race, a people you killed indiscriminately, women, children, civilians, not just soldiers. That is not an uprising in my book.
They are like weeds. Every root must be eliminated to prevent their return.
So you became even worse than your masters.
How dare you claim I have a master? We will destroy every Valmirian in this pitiful universe.
So you destroyed their race, their world, and then followed the survivors?
We trapped the survivors.
So you follow the survivors and you trap them on whatever world they're on, and then you basically slaughter indiscriminately just to be sure that you have killed that one individual. You are so much worse than your masters.
We will stop once our mission is complete. We have morals.
You don't know the meaning of the word!
You claim that I do not have morals, and yet you align yourself with the Valmirians.
No!
You can use that as much as you want now.
Why didn't you tell us?
How can I trust you?
But you did.
You're no villager. You're no Hagoff. Who are you?
I'm the stuff of legend.
My people. You made them what they are.
Come on, now's not the time. Let's get you up.
The blast was a death shock. I'm not going to make it.
And I have one of the most advanced hospitals in all of space and time, so let's just get you out of here.
No, Doctor. Get out of here. This is my justice.
So is this what happens then, Doctor? Wherever you go, you leave a trail of death and destruction.
Me and Isabel wanted to see the universe, and now look at it.
Dylan, it's not always like that. I mean, this happens, but we always try to do the right thing. I try to save everybody, but you can't save everyone. You try, but it's impossible. Do you know how hard it is to literally have to save every single person?
Yes, I do. It's my job, remember?
Then maybe me and you aren't that different. But the thing is, if you want to travel with me, you have to remember that what we do because it's the right thing. We do it because somebody has to. We carry on, we keep our heads up, and we be kind. Are you with me, Dylan?
Always. Right then, let's go find the rest of that screwdriver.
Wait.
What are you doing? You will pay for your obstruction of justice.
Oh, shut up!
I can tear you apart with my bare hands.
Oh, I'd like to see you try. You're worse than your masters ever were. Come on, let's take it.
Halt! Explain yourself or face doom.
I've seen doom that makes your war look like a child's game.
Soldier.
But not the same kind as you.
All I see is death, murder.
Oh, your friends are very much alive. They just need a charge. I've seen too much death and destruction for any soldier, so I'm taking you and your friends into my custody. These are their mind chips. I'm turning them over to the Shadow Proclamation, because then they will deal with you. Catch. Come on.
Right, boys. Let's go home.
Mom! On!
Doctor, what is it? What's wrong?
It's damage beyond repair. I'm sorry, Dylan. I failed you. There's no going back.
Yes, yes. Come on, Ogo, you can do it.
Oh, I love this power.
Doctor!
Isabella, you did it, well done.
Ogo, you can't.
Dylan! Dang it, Dylan! Dylan! Dylan!
No! Stop it!
Dylan! No, come on! Not now!
Stop it! No! No! No!
Dylan! Hurry up! The TARDIS is gonna tear this whole planet apart!
They got away. The cyborgs got away. They'll never face any kind of retribution or justice for their actions. You didn't.
I think I did.
Dylan! You're a genius!
To them, dying was better than captivity. To them, death was their final act of freedom.
You did the right thing.
But did I? They'd rather die than be taken to the Shadow Coffination. I mean, I'm no policeman. Is it my place?
So what are you gonna do?
Set them free.